Welcome back to RoboSense. So once your OS installation is done, whatever OS it is, you just need to find out the IP address of your system. And using software such as PuTTY, you can just log in as Pi and the password will be Raspberry. It is a pre-default password which is given by Raspberry Pi Foundation. So once this is done, the basic foremost important process is to go and configure the Raspberry Pi preferences basically. So here you can basically try out all the options given here, and most important is the interface options. And there you have to basically go and check out all these options and switch it on as per your requirements. So once these things are done, you can basically connect your system with PNC. You can connect it with wireless support. You do have the camera access switched on. Everything is done there. Also, if the VNC is switched on, you can just install a VNC viewer on your PC, and then you can just view all the full screen which is being showed on the Raspberry Pi to your virtual computer. In this way, there is a lot of things you can do, and this tutorial is basically for installing ROS Kinetic on this Raspbian. Therefore, just stay tuned and look after the process. It's quite a long process, so it will take some time. So okay, now I'm just logging into the Raspberry Pi computer. Now username would be Pi and password would be any password, but for now it is Raspberry. So once logging in, you can see we just entered into the Raspberry Pi desktop, and here we can do all the work we want to without having any screen, keyboard or mouse. So in this way we can do a lot of things. Now the foremost thing we need to do is we need to update and upgrade the system in order to have all the latest packages installed. And also we can check the preferences here, so we can do it with code or also with the UI. Because we are on the desktop, we can just use the UI, and here we'll try to see which things we have done, and just enable all these things which you know and which you need basically. So now basically we are trying to install ROS Kinetic on Raspbian, which is a bit difficult because there is a version mismatch basically with the OpenCV and other dependencies. So we'll try to match up all these things and, you know, update all the old lines of codes. Well, this would take a lot more time. There are at least 10 to 12 files we need to modify, and we need to replace some of the lines of codes. So just stay tuned and just watch it. And yeah. Well, to do it faster, all these files, so you can open multiple terminals at once, and you can just edit all these files parallelly. This way, you can have a good check on which files you have been editing and what are the lines you are editing. In this way, you can just minimize the rate of error, and this can help us the process of building, because the building process takes a rough amount of 1.5 hours for Raspberry Pi 4 and more than 3 hours in Raspberry Pi 3. So we do not need to repeat that process. So once this thing is done, we can basically go and build up the process, and then we can enjoy ROS Kinetic on Raspbian. Okay, all this process which I am doing is linked on one of the instructable pages. It is well mentioned there, but whatever they have done, this video shows them better. So the practical process you can see here. Otherwise, all this process, if you cannot see, if you cannot relate, then you can just go to that page, and obviously you can follow that. Well, once the process is completed, we'll just see how this works. So we'll just type our raw score, and you can see this works pretty fine. We are getting Auskinetic on Raspbian. But yes, we do not have all the dependencies installed, all the packages installed, so we have to build it again to get all these packages. Yeah, that is done.